There's only two things in life that make it worth living. It's guitars that tune good and firm, feeling women. I don't need my name in the marquee lights. I got my song, and I got you with me tonight. Baby, it's time we got back to the basics of love. Let's go to Lukenbach, Texas, with Waylon and Willie and the boys. This successful life we're living's got us feuding like the Hatfields and McCoys. Official. Official. Between Hank Williams' pain songs and Lou Berry's train songs and Blue Eyes crying in the rain. Out in Lukenbach, Texas, ain't nobody feeling no pain. That's not bad. Oh. All right. Well, soon, all of you are going to find out and realize, and I'm realizing it today, I may actually turn out to be a fat shit of peace. I may actually turn out to be a shit of peace. It may actually turn out to be true. Let's be patient and allow Father to get settled in. Father's army. Tío, ¿qué tal? Nada, ahí, tranquilo. Father's army. Father fills up swimming pools with piss for cookie cutters. I've been having a little conversation back and forth with Brad in the DMs. I'm going to tell Father all about it. All right, everyone, let's be patient. Do you want me to end this live and just wait until Father is ready? Father just texted me. He's just gotten to his hotel room. Yeah, you know, hold on a minute. Because this is the kind of stuff Brad wants. He wants the ball breaking back. Pomp's Postal Boy, Brad and Dale having a slumber party. Yeah, that's a good question. Do you think that Dale and Brad, like, they're gonna, where, like, let's say he's staying over at Dale's house, are they gonna like, you know, take the cushions off the couch and put them on the floor, and wear pajamas, and they're gonna watch like a late night horror movie and eat popcorn and drink some sodas? Whatever you say, Robzilla last mailbag, I'll post the screenshots. And I'll tag Brad. See, someone was mentioning that earlier. It's not over unless Brad says so. I'm going to post the screenshots. And I'm going to tag Brad. JC Miami 36, love you, Cuban. Donald Matthews, Expos. Thank God fucking baseball's back. Jesus Christ. Some kind of hate. Explain what's going on, Cuban. Well, it's been a crazy 48 hours. Been a crazy fucking 48 hours. That's all I gotta say. No, it's not Brad troll account, because it has the same messages on there that Brad and I have sent to each other in the past. For instance, more recently, I actually reached out to Brad and I sent him a message after he injured himself. He injured his knee walking the dogs. And I reached out to him, you know, jokingly, and said, just needs DECA, right? He answered me laughing. He goes, you know, I actually have some left. Lefty Nero, where Jay at? Jay is getting settled in his hotel. Like I said. Hold on a minute. I mean, I just want to be fair. Hold on a minute. Maurice, new mother in the house. Who the fuck is the new mother? What is with you guys wanting to replace Carolyn? What is the beef? What is the beef? O'Dwyer Racing, thoughts on Dale's obesity. You think Dale's obese? Robzilla, last mailbag. Gorilla Juice is the puppet master pulling the strings now. Whatever you say, dude. If there is no beef between me and Brad, and then if there's no beef between he and Jay, what does he have? What does he have? What does he have? I'm taking away the power. So now everyone is just a fucking asshole. I'm pretty sure himself and others that will remain nameless, and they know who they are, like a fucking shout out. I'm pretty sure they were getting a great laugh. They were laughing their asses off last night. They were having a great time. I'm sure some of them celebrated with alcohol. I'm sure they thought it was wonderful. And now, it looks like the wind is going to be taken out of their fucking sails. Human Young Juice is McCuck, bruh. See that? Did you see that? You think he's running from the cops? Well, he's gonna jump the fence. And that's a mean fence, man. Oof. I wouldn't want to fucking jump over that. Let's see if he makes it. He made it. Well, the cops are not following him. So. Yeah, it's just a jogger. Exactly, it's just a jogger. Fuck Doc 66. Never take lifting advice from a black guy. Negro, that's how I'm gonna address this from now on. This shit you guys wanting me to keep saying, I'm gonna address it in another way. What is Curtis? John Romano, huge upper lip. What is Curtis? Fuck Dog 66. Negros got the extra bone in they leg, in they leg, in they leg dog? Latch, it was a negro, yeah. Negros jumping for bananas. Janie Masterson, what have you been up to? What have you been up to, Kawano? Just working and... Oh, God, everything's finally coming to an end. Thank God. Latch Mayate. John Romano. John Romano, huge upper lip. That beer looks refreshing. You know, the only thing I can relate this to, this beer that I got, it's called Landshark. And unless I'm wrong, Jimmy Buffett, a local artist here in South Florida, I believe this is his beer. Yeah, Margaritaville Brewing. And, I mean, the only thing I can compare it to, it's an American Corona. I mean, it's the only thing I can compare it to. Latch, I'm all fucked up. Been drinking for hours straight. Jesus Christ. Yeah. Cataluna Data Bro McCut getting 400 DMs tomorrow. Yes. Yes. Jane Masterson, is it legal to drink while in a vehicle there? Even passenger? That's a good question. Allow me to talk about that for a moment because this will help you in the future. I don't know how it is in other states, but here in the state of Florida, yes, it is technically legal for me to drink in a vehicle as long as I'm nowhere near the keys of the vehicle. Now, let's say I'm completely shitty fucking drunk, right? And a cop comes up. Now, if as long as I don't have the keys to the vehicle, I'm fine, but I have to stay in a vehicle and hope to God the cop doesn't ask me to get out of the vehicle, because then that cop, if he's a real cunt, he can get me for being drunk in public. He won't get me for a fucking DUI, but he'll get me for being drunk in public. But I doubt a cop is just going to be that fucked up if I'm near my house. You know what I mean? So, always remember that. You can drink in a vehicle, just don't be anywhere near the fucking keys when a cop's around. Fuck dog six. Break out the tequila, Cuban. Let's get this party started. Mentally deep. Where's Jay? Jay's getting settled in right now. I'm just waiting for him to get settled in. That's all. Latch, I was in the driver's side with keys in the ignition and empty beer cans and just sent me home in California. Well, that's California. California right now, they're letting everyone get away with all types of degeneracy. It's just, not that sitting in your vehicle drinking is degenerate. I'm just saying. Thank you, Sea Park. Thank you, Sea Park Town. Chin looking stronger, Cuban. Thank you. Thank you. That's a compliment coming from you. Oh, he just hopped over the fence and he's coming back. He's just a jogger. Don't you love this town? I love this city. I love Riviera Beach. It's never a fucking dull moment. Never a dull moment. This is fantastic. Rob Sillum, last mailbag. I'm friends with 427. Who needs enemies? Negro alert. Palms Postal Boy. Diana above fourth dimension, JJJ, come on. Human Young Hope, you can't smell him. Fuck dog. We're not gonna talk about Brad's family anymore. Brad and I had an extensive conversation about terms. It fucking happened, guys. I hate to break the news to anyone out there that just wants all of the fucking chaos to continue. And all the fucking nutty bullshit. I'm taking away the power. Yeah, bachingo of wisdom, shit of peace. That may actually turn out to be true. Oh. Hold on. Just Ments, go live with Brad. Now, Brad is busy spooning with Dale. Robzilla's last mailbag was just stirring the shit before Herd 427 went rogue, even though others think otherwise. Fuckdog66, there's only one or two trolls who really attack Brad's family. Disco Duck, did Juice intimidate you into stabbing? I'm waiting for Father to come on here so I can explain to him the chain of events. Mentally deep, I can't see your comment. I don't know. You may have to do it again. Human Young, do you accept the terms from Bradley if he invites you and Jay for burnt steaks? No. If I go to his house, I'm bringing the fucking food. Send that to him right now. If I go to his house, if Jay and I are going to his house, I'm bringing the food. And I'm gonna fucking cook. You know, that's a good question. That's a good question, Pomp Spulse Boy. Is Brad and Dale doing Brokeback Mountaining? It's possible. Like, you know, I think it's a fair question. Are they going to have, like, a pajama party? Are they going to go into the living room? You know, is Brad staying with Dale? Are they going to go in the living room with pajamas on, take the cushions off the couch and lay them on the floor and watch scary movies together? You know, and drink soda and eat popcorn and candy. I'll repeat it. Is it true you and Jay are doxing trolls for Brad and Gorilla Juice? You know what? I'm going to address something right now. Okay? I'm going to address something right now just in case none of you know or are out of the loop and all that shit. Okay? Forgive me for digging up the past. Forgive me for digging up the past, but let's talk about the past for a moment, okay? I'm a grown-ass man. I'll tell you what I did, even if it makes me look bad, okay? Robzilla. I have my part in that. Yes. Yes. Did I partake in attacking him? Yes. Did I partake in trolling him, in doxing him? Yes, because I was looking for retribution after what he did to me. Now, after that, and even before that, haven't done it. Haven't done it. And believe it or not, Robzilla and I are actually good. And I apologize to him for my part in whatever happened to him. Now what? Now what? Jane Masterson, why did you leave Publix? Because Publix was... I posted it on one of my stories, and I think I posted it as a post for everyone to see on one of my accounts. I'm not shitting you guys. I'm not shitting you. Right now, Publix is allowing anyone, autistic, whatever you want to call it, they're allowing those individuals to get in managerial positions as long as they meet all of the requirements. If they can pass the test and they can run a department, mentally deep. Delray Misfits board says, yeah, I saw all that. If you want to believe any of that shit, you go right ahead. You go right ahead. I saw one screenshot of something that I know it's not fucking true. And Brad doesn't even fucking believe it. Okay? So, was Jason your manager? No, but that would be great, wouldn't it? Mentally deep. Gabriel, you're dodging the question. I haven't doxed anyone other than Robzilla. How much more clearly do I need to put that? How much more clearly do you want me to say that? I have not doxed anyone since Robzilla. Fuck dog. Gorilla Juice trying to dox BFD. Yeah, I saw that. Now we can expect Father now any moment. Anti-pumps defense force. McLeod won't fight in the piss. Just meant CC, do you miss Publix? Yeah. There's a part of me that does. Because in this new job that I have, I work by myself a lot. You're rarely around the other employees. And here he is, ladies and gentlemen, back by popular demand, Father.
What's up?
Father, we have much to address. It may actually look like that I've actually turned out to be a shit of peace.
Well, do I need to get out the Pooh Bear and you can show me on the Pooh Bear where they hurt you?
No. We don't need to go that far. We don't need to go that far.
Because, you know, not only am I an investigator, but I'm also a part-time psychologist.
Now, are you experienced and well-versed in trauma?
Anal?
Freudian slip. I mean, I'm not saying anything. I mean,
giving or receiving?
God damn it, Jay. Now I gotta talk about the position that I used to play in baseball, which fucking gives everything away. I was a catcher.
Well, that's better than Dale. They always put him at short.
You know, honest to God, because Dale has that bodybuilder build. He wouldn't be able to move fast. We would have to either make him a pitch hitter or a designated hitter or put him out in left field.
What about putting Dale in center field so he would have to run for the fly balls and we could see his little legs moving real fast?
Can you see him diving for a ball or going back to the fence and trying to reach for one?
Reach around, yeah. I'm full of it tonight. This is going to be fun. So,
Father, on and off today, Brad and I have been DMing each other. Now, Brad deserves a lot of credit. He deserves a lot of credit because he reached out to me.
I agree. You know,
he deserves a lot of credit. He reached out to me.
You know, I want to get something off my chest. I just had a tranny titty fuck me, and the cum is starting to get crusty. I just wanted to let the viewers know that any crude comments about Brad's kids, we're simply not going to read them. You know, it's a free country. We're not going to block you. We're not going to kick you out of the live. So go knock yourself out. But if you want your comment read, don't include a minor. Don't use the N-word. Other than that, do we have any other rules besides those two?
Actually, I've gotten around the N-word. Whenever they have the N-word, I'm just going to say it in Spanish. Negro. I'm just going to say it in Spanish.
I could say Mulian.
Eggplant.
Well, if you say Muli, they all know what you're talking about. You got to dress it up a little bit and say it properly. So anyway, now that I got that off my chest, because I agree with you, Brad doesn't deserve this. You know, this person who's creating these fake screenshots and creating all this drama is keeping a certain person who will remain nameless, who's under the age of 18, the topic of conversation around the Genovaverse. It's not me. It's not you. It's not even those two fools yesterday that were posting inappropriate selfies that had been screen photoshopped. It's this guy, because they were reacting to him. It's this guy who's keeping this young person, I'll say, the topic of the conversation. And Brad doesn't deserve that, you know? I mean, and I don't deserve it, because I'm getting blamed for it all. So everyone needs to just let it die. We're not going to perpetuate it. We're not going to read the you know, I used to skirt around the rules. You know, and this is it's the oldest trick in the book. I was just reading comments. Okay? I know what I'm doing when I'm just reading comments. I'm not stupid. I know what I'm doing. But you know what? I'm not even going to do that anymore. I've had it, because these assholes will chop up a video and take you reading a comment completely out of context and make it look like you're the person saying it.
You know, and Brad was explaining that to me about certain things that you thought that he said, and he basically said the same thing. He basically said the same thing. And when he and I talked further, he knows that screenshot's fake.
Right.
Or screenshots. So
it's so obvious that smiling emoji looked so fucking fake. I mean, come on, man. Get better at your Photoshop skills.
Next thing you know, we're going to have a real skilled troll. A really skilled troll do a deep fake of you. Then you've really made it.
Did you really make it? That screenshot where they said Cuban found new pictures, the one we're talking about. You notice that the person who said that in the chat group, it said user not found. That's fake.
Interesting.
That's fake as fuck. Why would it say user not found if the person was in the chat group chatting? That makes no sense. No sense at all.
Hey, Bruno's in the house. What's up, Bruno? It doesn't matter who started it. It's over, guys.
Yeah.
You ever seen the movie First Blood? It's over, Johnny. It's over.
Right. It's not fair to Brad, and it's not fair to me. You know, this was our little quarrel, you know, and I don't want to get into how it started and what I did to retaliate. That's, you know, Joe Piattaro said today, you're both wrong. What he was saying about your mom is wrong, and what you did to retaliate doesn't make you any better. Hey, you both were wrong. Get over it. Move on. End it. It's over. But we got a certain motherfucker who's keeping it the hottest story in the Genovaverse. And the fans out there, fans, trolls, piss troopers, misfit maniacs, whatever you want to call the people, they're falling for it hook, line, and sinker. You know?
Even Brad told me he doesn't give a shit what we say, break his balls, whatever. You know, like I was just saying, you know, Brad, I think, isn't Brad staying with Dale? So, you know, they're going to have a slumber party. They're going to dress in pajamas. They're going to pull the cushions off the couch and lay them on the floor. They're going to watch scary movies together and drink soda and eat popcorn and candy, you know. And Brad's head is huge. He and I need to change heads. My head is too small for my body. His head is too big for his. We need to exchange heads.
Yeah, there was a picture on Cornelius's page of Brad, Cornelius, and Dale. And I wrote in the comments, Dale gets third place in this picture. Yeah, you know, I have no anger against Brad. I think Brad's more mad at me than I am at him. Because I've probably been dealing...
Father, he's over it, Jay. I'm telling you, he's over it. He just wants it to end, man. He's over it.
I agree. And certain trolls, well, one in particular, is keeping this the hot topic in the Jehovahverse.
He's not alone. I'm telling you right now, he's not alone. There were individuals that will remain nameless. You know who they are. They were all laughing last night. They were all fucking laughing last night. Now what? Now what?
Yeah, McCuck's going to wake up to 50 DMs tomorrow morning about this. I wish McCuck would give me a call. I don't think I have his number anymore.
You know what you missed while you were getting us situated and everything?
I was getting titty fucked by a tranny.
Dry? Man, don't you get? No, you should have chafe.
Blood, sweat, or tears. We were using prison lube.
There we go. Oh, Brill cream. Listen. There was a guy I used to work for, and he was in the state prison in Mississippi back in the '60s. And he said, if you were walking around or whatever, or you were in your cell, and you smelled Brill cream, somebody was fucking.
You know, Dale, Cornelius, and Brad were all in their gym shoes, so you can get a fair analysis of everybody's height, because they all had sneakers on. And Brad's not an incredibly tall man. You've met Brad in person. What do you think he is? 5'9", 5'10"?
I say double digits as far as the inches. It's 5'10".
Okay. We'll give him 5'10". Dale's not 5'7". Okay. Well, does Dale claim he's 5'8" or 5'7"? I forget.
5'8".
I think Dale might be taller than Cornelius. I'm not sure. Man,
was Cornelius standing on his toes?
I don't know, but you know, these guys claim to be bodybuilders, and standing next to Brad, who's just a postman, they don't look like bodybuilders. I mean, obviously Dale's calves are twice the size of Brad's, but other than that, it's not like, oh, look at those bodybuilders dwarfing that mailman. Oh, on the contrary.
Dale's in the chat.
Is he?
He's like, oh, wow, you're still on my height.
We love you, Dale.
Listen, I'm not blowing smoke up Dale's ass. Enough time has gone by for his muscle to mature and the elasticity of his skin and everything. And I'll keep my promise, Dale. If you ever want to do a show down here at the Ruby, I'll show up with as many maniacs as I can. We'll all have our faces painted like fucking misfits, and we'll show up, and you'll hear us.
It doesn't make any sense for Dale to waste the time, the money, and the effort to do a Rudy Poot show like the Ruby. That all that's going to get him is a plastic fucking trophy. That's no national qualifier. I don't think.
Yeah, but it'll be a first-place trophy.
Yeah, that's true.
He'll put all of this behind him.
Yeah. I'd like to see Dale play to win the game.
He would. He could do both. He could do this show here, and he could do a local show.
Well, he needs to do a national qualifier. I don't know. The Ruby's literally Rudy Poot. Rudy Poot Ruby.
I love you, man. You're fucking all or nothing. You're all or nothing. Jesus Christ. Oh. Yeah, but no bullshit, man. There's enough. There's been enough time for Dale that his muscle has matured, the elasticity of his skin, all that shit. He ever steps on stage again, he'll bring his best look. He's going to look better than he's ever done before.
Yeah. I can't believe how heavy he trains back, and I believe his bicep is attached to the bone with a screw.
He tore his bicep?
Yeah, his bicep was off the bone, I'm pretty sure.
God damn. Dale just said that the Ruby is a national qualifier.
Ah.
You said, hey, all or nothing. All or nothing. Well, you didn't say it. I said all or nothing. All or nothing.
You know, Dale knows my opinion. I've said it 100 times. He needs to come in at 198 or whatever it is to make the light heavy class so he doesn't have to stand out there against the guys that are 6 inches taller than him. It's too tough to win the heavyweight division at his height. I mean, I'm not putting him down. I think he has a better chance to win first place in the light heavyweight division, 198, whatever it is, 90 kilo. You European guys can do the conversion, 90 kilo, I believe. You know.
And at the same time, if he brings his best look, let's say he follows your advice, he wins that. And if he, I'm saying if he brings his best look, I think he could win the overall.
At 198, yes. He could maybe win the overall at 198. Whereas his ego is, and Cornelius for one, I would fire Cornelius because Cornelius is putting it in his head. Dale, you can come on stage at 220. So Dale comes on stage at 220, soft as a baby's bottom, standing next to guys that are 6 inches taller than him and gets a third place trophy. That's not how you win the fucking game. Go down to 198, get sliced and diced, and stand next to men your fucking height and win the fucking show. And say, look, fuckers, this is what a first place trophy looks like. All you motherfuckers that doubted me. That's how you play to win the game.
That would be menty as fuck. Him winning that, looking at the camera, now what? Now what?
Right. What do you want me to do next, motherfuckers? I'm qualified for nationals. I got a first place trophy. Fuck all of you. No, but he's got Cornhole whispering in his ear, you know, Dale, you need to be 220 on stage. Come on, man. If Dale was 220 on stage ripped, he'd be like Lee Priest size.
Yeah, Lee Priest, I think he used to say that it would always be around 198, 200, 202. He was always around that weight.
I didn't think they had the 212 Olympia back then.
No, he had to compete. That's the one thing I will give Lee Priest credit for. Motherfucker, when he competed, it was like in this time where he's in a lineup with fucking Dorian Yates, Paul DeLette, you know, the guy that you like, Kevin Lavrone, you know, name all the names, guys. He's in a lineup with all those dudes, and he got sixth against all those dudes.
Right. Kevin Lavrone is the Dale Chance of second place. How many second place Mr. Olympias does Kevin Lavrone have? Minimum of three, right? And two.
There's one guy I'm forgetting that was always coming in second to Dorian besides Kevin Lavrone. I'm forgetting his name. He was a small guy.
Conrad.
He that now that guy has something that no other bodybuilder has. He, for so many years in a row, he's always placed top five in the Olympia.
Well, I believe Kevin Lavrone got second to Dorian and then to Ronnie. Right. And then got second to Ronnie. Kevin had the misfortune of overlapping the two greatest of all time, Dorian Yates and Ronnie Coleman. That's pretty bad fucking luck.
Did you ever hear Kevin Lavrone's story about Ronnie Coleman? Did you ever hear that story?
No.
We'll wait for Father to get back.
Now,
so anyway, Ronnie Coleman, Hurricane. Ronnie Coleman still hasn't won a pro show yet, right? He has his pro card. So they're at the hotel. And I guess Kevin Lavrone must have invited Ronnie to his hotel room, or Ronnie went to him and they were talking. And he looks at Ronnie Coleman. He's like, you know, Ronnie, man, I understand about taking all this seriously and everything, but look at you. You came into my hotel room. You've got your fucking meal plan with you, your bottle of water. You need to relax, man. And Ronnie's like, well, how do I do that? Kevin Lavrone, because he had just made it, he gets a cup of coffee for him. And he gets vodka, and he puts vodka into the coffee, and he hands it to Ronnie. And Ronnie's like, oh, come on, Kevin. You know I don't drink no damn vodka. Come on, man. You know I don't drink no vodka. He's like, Ronnie, you need to relax. So Ronnie drinks a cup of coffee with the vodka. And then next thing you know, Ronnie's like, man, I sure like that vodka. I sure like that vodka. The very next day when they went to do the show, fucking Ronnie Coleman wins the fucking show.
That's because the coffee and the vodka dehydrated him.
And Lavrone realized, holy fuck, I fucking helped him win. Now, oh, shit.
Back in the old days, bodybuilders used to drink a bottle of red wine the night before the show. Because it might be the Revestatrol, or what's it called? What is it in? Or no, the histamines. The histamines in red wine bring out your vascularity.
You know who religiously drank that wine that you're talking about, the red wine?
Frank Zane.
Yes. He was religious about it.
He won the Mr. Olympia at like 176 or something ridiculous.
Three fucking times.
Oh, he won it once, the year that Arnold didn't do it. 78.
Bro, if you look it up, I'm telling you, I think Frank Zane won the Olympia three times. I might be wrong.
He won it the year Arnold didn't do it. 79. He might have won the universe three times.
Anyway. Oh, my God. The feral cat that we have, she's come all the way from the backyard to up front here to see me. Holy shit.
I've got a prediction for tonight's photograph.
Okay.
Dale won't be wearing sneakers. Brad will be wearing his dress sneakers. I don't know what Cornelius...
Hi, Jeff!
That was gay.
I had to do that because he got pissed off at me last night for not saying hi to him.
Dale is going to break out those...
No, I was talking about somebody else.
Dale's going to break out the custom cowboy boots that have an extra inch in the heel.
I had to break my neighbor's balls there for a minute.
What is a standard cowboy boot, I think, has a 2-inch heel?
Yeah.
Well, you can get him with a three-inch heel. That's what Dale has. Dale will be towering above Brad tonight if they go out.
Oh, they'll be the same exact height. Oh, God. This is what everyone wants, the ball breaking, the fun and shit. This is what the majority of what everyone wants.
You know, I don't mind cowboy boots. I think the dress sneakers are much more gay. What's gayer than dress sneakers, for Christ's sakes?
Okay, well, I'll ask your opinion on this. You tell me your opinion. This is what I think is cool if you do this, and I'm only exclusively talking about this. Let's say you've got a nice suit, right?
Yeah.
A suit, tie, right? And you wear high top Chuck Taylors, Converse.
I can't fit in Chuck Taylors. I have fat feet.
Well, I understand that, but what do you think of that look?
I would have to wear high top Vans.
So you're not against it, if it's in that context.
A suit or a sport coat jacket with slacks?
No. A suit. I'm talking about a suit.
Okay. A suit, you wear dress shoes. If you're wearing a sport coat jacket with slacks, you can wear any shoes you fucking want. And I'll tell you guys what. Jay,
that's the Chevy Chase look.
Yeah.
That's the Chevy Chase look. That's fine too. That's great.
Right. The way to know the difference between a suit coat and a sport coat is the suit coat is going to have the color keyed buttons on the wrist. Like if you're wearing a blue suit, the buttons are going to be blue. If you're wearing a sport jacket, they're going to be gold. So when you see this is a bad, bad fashion look. Sometimes guys will wear a suit coat like it's a sports coat. Like they'll have blue jeans, cowboy boots, and a suit coat. You don't do that with a suit coat. You want to wear.
I agree.
You want to wear a sports jacket, a sport coat. You can wear a sport coat with anything you want. You can wear a sport coat with a wife beater. I don't care. Just don't wear a suit coat with a wife beater. Yeah, wear inappropriate use of a suit coat is the sign of somebody that wasn't raised right.
That's something my mom would say.
Right.
Oh my God.
Well, I mean, even if you don't have a lot of money, even if you were raised poor, you might have one suit that you wear for weddings and funerals. You're not going to wear that to the bar with your jeans, and you're not going to wear that jacket to the bar with your jeans and cowboy boots, because that's the only suit you got. You got to protect it. Now, you go to the store and get a fucking $100 sport coat. There you go. You can do anything you want in a sport coat. You don't even have to wear slacks. You can wear khakis. You can wear jeans. You can wear shorts and cowboy boots for all I fucking care. Fashion tips from the bedroom bully, man who wears Crocs.
Don't knock the Crocs, man. My 17-year-old is discovering the wonders of Crocs. She fucking loves them. And she's very disgruntled that her school does not allow the kids to wear Crocs.
Well,
they don't allow them to.
Florida schools has a no flip flop rule.
And for some reason, they consider Crocs flip flops. I don't get that.
They're not. Now, you know how I started wearing Crocs? I used to wear slides, which are the sandals where you slide your foot in, and there's no thong in between your toes. I used to wear slides. I love slides. And when I first started truck driving, I was using slides as my shower shoes. Because you don't go barefoot in the shower unless you're a retard. Oops, am I allowed to say the word retard? I hope no one is recording this and sends it to my work. Anyway, I was wearing slides as my shower shoes because that's what I prefer. And truck stop parking lots are so fucking filthy that sometimes walking back to my truck, my wearing slides after a fresh shower, my fucking feet were dirty. Who the fuck wants dirty feet if you get out of the fucking shower? That's hillbilly as fuck.
It defeats the purpose.
Right. I just showered. Well, you got dirty feet, son. You know what I mean? So I bought the Crocs to keep my feet cleaner.
Someone just suggested you say imbecile.
Imbecile. We pronounce it differently. Imbecile.
Imbecile.
I speak with a Michigan accent. Crucify me.
That reminds me of when I was younger, my dad had a real bad toothache. And my grandfather came over and we both went to the local drugstore to get him something. And I remember my dad telling me, now listen, I need you to go to the store and get me Ambisol. If you forget how, if you get what it's called, just remember the name imbecile.
That's how Archie Bunker would say it.
The world needs Archie Bunker and George Jefferson right now.
Yeah. If I had a toothache, I would just go to the corner drug dealer and get a gram of cocaine. Oh, did I say that? I hope no one records that and sends that to my work. Oh. So, I've been trying to call our fallen comrade, 427 Corvette. Because I have his phone number. And because I don't like to see someone suffer. Even if they fucked up. Big J is going to be the one to give you a helping hand back up. And I've been trying to call the guy all day, and his phone has been turned off all day, straight to fucking voicemail. And I have a feeling that kid, and I call him a kid, he's 27 years old, and he's a 290-pound man. I have a feeling that kid crawled inside a whiskey bottle last night. And you know, a lot of people think he's a fucking scumbag, and he's not. What he did was a fuck up. Good people fuck up. And he fucked up. I'm not defending the kid, but I'm not ready to flush him down the fucking toilet like everybody else. He fucked up. He fucked up. He said he was fucking sorry. You know? And I'm pissed at him for making that fucking video too. I told him not to. Don't be a fucking pussy. The post has been deleted by Instagram. The post is already gone. Why are you being a pussy? And he went ahead and was a pussy and made that apology video. And now there's troll accounts with his name and pictures from his Facebook. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. But I've been trying to call him all day. His phone has not been turned on all day. I don't know if he had to work today. If he might have called in sick. He was not feeling good last night. I was a little rough on him last night, but he didn't listen to me.
Brad is on here now.
He did not listen to me.
No, listen, forgive me for being an insensitive, heartless, whatever you want to call me. Call me a sociopath, whatever. I only have two feelings about what happened. One, no one fucking told him to fucking do that.
That's true.
No one fucking told him to fucking do what he did.
Hey.
Okay? And in that, he was stupid. Okay? And at the same time, I don't think the kid should be killed either.
No. He's a he made a bad, bad decision. You know, as Americans, we don't flush the people down the toilet for one bad decision. For Christ's sakes. And the United States of America is a very forgiving place. If you apologize for what you did and admit you're a retard, the public will always take you back. Go through history and look at the people that have apologized for a major fuck-up. The public always takes them back. Now, they didn't take O.J. Simpson back because he never apologized. See what I'm saying?
Yeah, but if you're his lawyer, you tell him, don't apologize because then it's an admission of guilt.
Right. There's no statute of limitations on a murder, I believe. I that's a bad example. We can come up with a better one, but let's just move on. So 427 is a fucking idiot, a moron, a 27-year-old kid, a meathead. And no one told him to do that. And I know why he did it. We even joked around about why he did it. Because earlier in the night, Zach, that other psycho fucking account, Gorilla Juice had reposted Zach, a picture of Zach, in, you know, with the black T-shirt on. I think he was wearing a ski mask. And Gorilla Juice said, I'm shaking in my knickers. And 427, honest to God, I think he got a little bit fucking jealous. And he went off the fucking deep end and did something in Photoshop he should have never done. And did that post challenging Gorilla Juice, post this, be my puppet. Wow. Look where that got you, brah. Look, you know. No one told him to do that. No one told him to do that. And if he ever comes back, he'll admit it. No one told him to do that. And you know,
As I stated last night at nauseam, you want to insert yourself in all this. You want to be part in all this. You think you're having fun. You think it's all fucking fun and games and everything. Well, it's all shits and giggles until someone actually giggles and shits themselves. So,
yeah.
This is the piss, man, and it's fucking unrelenting. There is no fucking mercy, nothing.
Oh. I'll tell you what. Honest as Abraham Lincoln, after he posted that, I was in such shock yes, I did send that post to a few people. Prince Andrew will vouch for me. I sent it to Prince Andrew because I wanted Andrew to know what somebody was doing to Brad's daughter. And so Gorilla Juice starts fucking posting fucking, you know, bullshit. The Big J spreading this around the internet. Big J's a pedo. No. Not so fast, my friend. That wasn't my screenshot. That wasn't my post. I was letting people know something fucked up happened. That isn't spreading it around. Andrew will vouch for me. I sent that to Andrew last night. I sent it to probably three or four people. People that I can trust, or obviously someone I can't, because it got back to Gorilla Juice. I had shared it with a couple people. I wasn't spreading it around. I was trying to let people know, look what just went down. This is fucked up. That I like that kid. He's a nice kid. But man, is he a fucking moron. An idiot.
Listen, I don't blame him for making the apology video. You know, I honestly really don't, because of his mom. I even said to him, dude, do whatever you gotta do to protect your mom, man. I don't fucking judge you. Do whatever you gotta do.
Yeah. You know, when it comes to doxing, you know, Prince Andrew always likes to say, there's no putting the toothpaste back in the tube. So, you want to make deals with people that just doxed you? You can't put the toothpaste back in the tube. So, once you make a deal with someone that doxed you, you're basically a dancing marionette.
Now, in hindsight, what he should have done, if he was truly, truly in panic and worried about his mom and everything, he should have made a video on his own account saying, listen, I fucked up. And this is what I did wrong, and I'm done. In hindsight, he probably would have been better off doing that.
Maybe. So. Do you think Big Brad Wolf gives two fucks either way?
No, because as you said, as Prince Andrew has been quoted and saying, that the toothpaste is out of the tube, man. It's not going back in.
Right. You can apologize to your blue in the face. It's not like Big Brad Wolf felt better about it because Gorilla Juice posted some basically a forced apology. I mean, Pom's poster boy, father, such a kind heart.
A father has love to give.
Humanity.
Now, as and I stated this before, now it's time to be focused. Now it's time to be focused. The enemies are out in the open. We all know who they are. People are mentioning Big Rob Fitness. People are mentioning Pumps. People are mentioning Gorilla Juice.
How is Big Rob Fitness an enemy?
I'm just saying. Because people lost focus.
Big Rob Fitness would hop on an airplane right now and go to Wales for me.
That would be menty as fuck.
He's not an enemy. He'll get loud in the city. I don't think Makaka's an enemy.
Oh.
I wish Adam McLeod would call me with all this shit going down. That's a great Adam McLeod quote. There's a lot of shit going on behind the scenes. Too busy for the podcast right now. There's a lot of shit going on behind the scenes.
Well, you know what he would say to you. What did you expect to happen?
I had a great conversation with Adam the last time he called me. The absolute only cringy thing Adam said, and I don't think he'll mind me sharing this, but I'm not going to share anything else about the conversation. Adam said, Jay, I want you to consider this phone call between you and I kind of like the church scene between the Highlander and the Kurgan. We're on holy ground.
Yes.
I'm just like, Jesus fucking Christ. Is this guy filming his conversation with me? Who the fuck would say something like that? I mean...
God, that, I love that movie. Damn it. You have the manners of a goat and you stink like a dung heap.
You stupid haggis.
What's a haggis?
It's a sheep's stomach stuffed with meat and barley.
That's revolting.
What do you do with it? Do you eat it?
That's revolting.
Fucking awesome movie. They ruined the Highlander when they did the sequel and made it about aliens.
The third one wasn't any better either.
I don't know if I've ever seen that.
I suggest you don't. It may be 90 minutes of your life you'll never get back.
Now, for some of you young guys that don't know what a compact disc is, we used to actually buy music. And it would come on a round disc. Yes, exactly. Yes, a compact disc. I used to have Highlander, the soundtrack, which was all Queen, and it was fucking badass.
The actual album is called A Different Kind of Magic.
It's a Kind of Magic.
Yes, It's a Kind of Magic. That's the name of the album, yes.
It's incredible.
Oh my God, that opening scene with that song, here I am, I'm the master of your destiny. Oh my God. Here we are, born to be kings. We are the princes of the universe. Wow.
Ryan.
And then that dude, that fucking one song, it's like, whoever wrote this shit, I don't know if it was Freddie Mercury or not, the Cubans have a saying, my God, that stuff that was written in those songs, how is your head not fucking empty? You know what I mean? That the one song, Who Wants to Live Forever, where you see the Highlander's wife and
Heather.
Oh my God. And she's aged and he's still with her and everything. He stayed with her until she died. And fuck me, man. Jesus Christ.
Oh, Heather. He talks about her sheepskin boots.
And then the other scene where Kurgan is going over the bridge and he's listening to the local radio. A man's decapitated head was found and da-da-da-da-da. And police still have not identified him. They don't know his name. I know his name.
What was he driving? I'd like to...
It was a Cadillac.
What's it?
He was driving a Cadillac.
Yeah, that was a great movie. Ryan from Scotland, I think he's Scotland. He said, I had that album on cassette.
That's real OG shit right there.
Yeah.
That's real OG shit. And I know it was a white cassette because I had it.
Oh, that was
we got all these people requesting to go live, but we need to stay focused.
The only person I would go live with would be the real Andrew from fucking Wales.
We know that's not going to happen because we both have sound theories about that. As far as, like, for instance, forgive me for disclosing a private discussion that we had, but you had disclosed to me something that I was completely ignorant about, that apparently the original Gorilla Juice has I'm not judging, he has a drinking and a cocaine problem. And he could very well be back on the alcohol and cocaine if it's the original Gorilla Juice, and he doesn't want to go live, and he doesn't want friends, family members, and maybe even coworkers. Not, you know, he doesn't want them to see him that way.
His sponsor.
So, sponsor.
Sponsor in the 12-step program. He probably can't let his sponsor know he relapsed. And sobriety might be part of his retaining his employment.
Yeah, we don't know the legalities in Wales. That is a sound theory. We don't know how they handle things legally over there as far as the job.
Well, I can tell that people outside the United States don't have the same rights. Like Transform X thinks that what 427 Corvette did last night needs the police involvement.
The police need physical evidence. They need a victim.
Dude.
They need a victim.
I can put fucking tits in a hairy bush on Queen Elizabeth with a Sharpie. That's not a fucking crime. I can put a mustache on Margaret Thatcher. That's not a crime. But in their country, it is, because they don't have free speech. You deface the queen, you can go to jail. So these people, they think we live like they do. They don't understand. We have pretty much absolute freedom. Pretty much absolute freedom. The only people that can get us are the woke mob. The government can't do anything. They really can't, because we have constitutional rights. The only thing that can get us is the woke mob. So, and they've already tried that. Hashtagging all my videos with hashtag BLM. That didn't work. Come on, man.
I just got a baseball update on your Tigers.
Huh. Opening day. They got the Yankees, right?
I forgot, but thank God baseball's back. Jesus Christ. At least I'm just saying that for myself. Thank God baseball's back.
Yeah, I follow the Detroit Tigers on Instagram. I've seen pictures. Looked like there was a lot of open seats. And for opening day, that's rare.
Well, the same thing happened in the Obama era. The gas prices got so fucking high. The food got so fucking high. Barely anybody was going to games. One of the things, and I don't know if they still do it anymore, one of the things that the Atlanta Braves tried to combat that with and fill their seats, they told people, you can bring your own food. You can bring your own cooler. Okay? And then the seats got filled. When they found out they didn't have to buy any fucking beer.
Well, you know, at
the baseball game or any fucking peanuts or anything, they filled the seats.
I got peanuts in my poop.
It's fibering, bro.
You know, at NASCAR races, if you have a soft cooler, you can bring a six-pack soft-sided cooler into the race.
Oh, a six-pack of tall boys, yeah.
Yeah, right. You got to get the extended zipper.
That's right.
Oh, Jamie Masterson is on here. Boy, is she
beautiful. Who is that? Who is that?
A very tubby female that's very attractive.
Is that you in another universe as a tranny?
Yes.
Fantastic.
I would sleep with myself.
She could probably throw me around in the bedroom.
You know, we're naturally attracted to people that look like ourselves. You know, our ego is stronger than people think.
I made that mistake with my first marriage. Didn't make it again. Hugh Young, is father a lesbian? Don't be so judgy. Mentally deep, please forgive me.
Oh, I wonder if Brad and Dale are still glued to this to see if I get fucked up and start going off on them. I'm not going to do it. I like Dale.
Hold on. We're pausing. He's probably on the hotel Wi-Fi. Fuck.
I get kicked off.
You were pausing, and it's either the hotel Wi-Fi or reception.
Nah, I made the mistake of not going on the hotel Wi-Fi. Someone, and we probably know who it is, just sent me a text message saying Brad wants to fight you bare knuckle.
And until you have video evidence of Brad saying that, you don't, you know, yeah.
Brad has my number.
Like I said, it's over.
If Brad wants to fight me bare knuckle, he could put a postcard in my mom's mailbox.
And then you get a phone call from your mother. What the fuck is this? What the fuck is this? Because my mom would do the same thing. What the fuck is this?
Brad wants all these problems to go away. Brad's moving on with his fucking life. Brad's not stuck in the Genovaverse.
Oh.
Someone on here just said something about Brad's going to spit in your mom's box. Brad's never said anything that disrespectful. He did say he was going to fuck her. But he never said he was going to spit in her box. I don't care. I'm in a good mood, Tio. Nothing's going to get me down.
I forgot what song that is. There's a song that says that.
Nothing's going to get me down?
Fuck, what song is that? Anyway, father's pausing again. Probably getting a phone call. There we go.
Whoever our friend is in Wales is obviously starting to text me.
Desperate now. Now I got him desperate.
Andrew in Wales, I will gladly leave this live so that you can debate the Cuban one-on-one. Show your face. I don't need to be here. I've been on camera so much in the past 10 years. I can easily give you my chair, Andrew from Wales. Come on, brah. Quit texting me. Go live with the fucking Cuban. I'll leave this live. Oh.
Not going to happen. Whoever it is obviously has something to hide. Not going to happen.
Jamie Masterson just said it could be a troll. No, it's not. Trolls are not meant killers. When you text or call a person doing a live stream, that's a meant killer. Our fans, the piss troopers, the misfit maniacs, the real fans of the Genovaverse are not meant killers.
Oh, shit.
Last thing they want to do is kill the meant. Okay? I don't care who you like, who you don't like. You don't kill the meant. You let them, like, if you can't stand Big Rob Fitness and he's doing fucking Get Loud in the City number 2, you don't start calling him in the fucking middle of it, you fucking moron, because Chuck E. Cheese Ranch is fucking gonna post it later, you dipshit. You don't kill ments. He just texted me again, and he did a woo like Pomps would. I mean, I could leave this live stream, and I could put my phone on fucking airplane mode and connect to the hotel Wi-Fi and go through all the rigmarole. It's just not worth it for one piece of shit. Oh, my God. Jamie Masterson asked me what size fleshlight I use.
Kathy Willits. That's the only thing I can think of.
Let Big Rob loose on Gorilla Juice. That's the Delray Ripper. The account that uses Andrew's face.
Someone just asked me, hold on a minute, someone just asked me, Cuban, you still good with Robzilla? And that's 4103J. Last time I spoke to Rob, yes. And I apologize to Rob for my part in his misery.
Yeah, you know,
it's over, guys. It's over.
Yeah, you talked about Robzilla the other night, and I think you went on a little bit too long because you read a comment, and you said Rob's moved on, Rob's doing his own thing, Rob's doing good, and then you should have shut up. You talked about Rob for about 90 seconds too long. I don't want to sound like an asshole, but that's what you did.
No, we're brothers, man. You tell me anything.
You talked about Robzilla for about 90 seconds too long. You read the comment. You said Rob's doing his own thing. Rob's doing real well. Rob's moved on. That's where you should have stopped. But you kept talking about Rob for about 90 more seconds. And that's when these assholes are going to fucking capture the video and take what you say out of context, send it to Rob. Oh, Cuban's talking shit about you. You know what I'm saying?
No, you're right. You're absolutely right.
I'm not saying you did anything wrong. I'm just saying you talked about Robzilla for about 90 seconds too long.
And it goes back to what I've said to you before, less is more.
Yeah.
Less is more.
With the exception of tranny cock. More is more. See, I want someone to send that to my work because if my work finds out that I'm in a relationship with a transgender person, they could never fire me because of the lawsuit.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Do I qualify if I say my wife uses a strap-on? That's something for the trolls to work on. Get a woman with a strap-on and Photoshop my face on a guy.
I'm not going to get hard.
Oh, shit.
Mentally Deep just said, why decline? I can answer that question. The decline press is actually the only press that involves the entire pectoral muscle. And one of the advantages of the decline is the short range of motion, especially if you have a big belly. So you can actually use the decline as an overload exercise, kind of like power lifters that bench down to those 2x4s you've seen in videos, and you're wondering, why are they doing that? Why are they putting boards on the chest? Well, that's an overload. They're doing more weight than they can handle. That's why they're putting the 2x4s on the chest. If you don't want to be a gay power lifter, which I agree with, just do decline. That's your overload. Because if you're not declining more than you flat bench, you're declining wrong. The decline should be a belly bench. It should be a short range of motion. And so that's why the decline is the perfect second exercise. You bench first, right? Because that's the competitive event, right? That's what you compete in, is the flat bench press. So you're going to do that first. Then you go to your decline, which involves the entire pectoral muscle. So it's good for bodybuilding, but it's also good for powerlifting because it's got a shorter range of motion and you can do an overload. So like, let's say you finish, whatever you finish your top set on the flat bench, you're already warmed up. You can pretty much start there on the decline. You don't have to warm up again. Like say you're a guy that benches 225 for 10, okay? We're going to base this on a 300-pound bencher because that's probably what most our fans are. Like say you're a 225 for 10 guy and you work up to your top set.
Damn it. There we go.
Hey, Tubby, Brad wants an answer. Yeah, I'll bare knuckle Brad. Send Brad 50 text messages and McCuck too. But anyway, back to what we were talking about. So let's say your top set of flat bench is 225 for 10. You can go to the decline. You don't need to warm up. You're already warmed up. You can duplicate that 225 for 10 as your first set and then go up from there. See what I'm saying? Now, I was so anal about my percentages when I was competitive powerlifting. Like back in the day, when I was a 300-pound bencher, let's just say my top set of bench was, I don't know. I don't want to get too specific and draw up the conversation. Let's just say I did a 225 for 10 on the flat. I would go to the decline next. I would never start with 225 because my central nervous system had already adapted to 225. Why would I want to train my body to get stronger if I've already done 225? So my first set of decline would be 230. Even though that wasn't going to be my top set, I never wanted to let my nervous system rest. I wanted there to always be an overload. So let's just say it. I get off the flat bench at 225 for 10. I hop on the decline. I do 230 for 10. And then I start adding weight for a couple more sets. That's an overload because basically the decline is a belly bench. And then I would go back for my third exercise. I would go back to the flat bench and I would do my close grips for my triceps. First and thirds. The philosophy of first and thirds. You want your third exercise to be as close as possible to your first exercise if you want to gain strength. You're using that second range of motion to actually give the first range of motion a little bit of rest. So your first and thirds are very closely related. You do something a little bit different second. So I would do bench first, obviously. That's a competitive event. Then I would decline second. And I would use that with the overload principle because I could decline more than I could flat bench. So like if I was pyramiding up on the flat bench, instead of going down on the flat bench, I would just hop on the decline and keep going up. Okay? Nervous system, you're tricking your nervous system. You just switched angles and you're still going up. Your nervous system doesn't know you switched benches. All it knows is the weight keeps getting heavier and heavier. And then you after like, I only recommend that for about three sets of decline. And then you go back to the flat bench, which is closer to your first exercise, and you do three more sets. But obviously you're going to have to drop about 90 pounds. Your decline should be approximately a 45 on each side heavier than your close grip. So whatever you finish with on your decline, go back to the flat bench and do your close grips third and pull a plate off. Strip 90 pounds off the bar and do your close grips for triceps. And that's the most simple fucking bench press program anybody could ever come up with. It's benching for dummies. And I'm a dummy. I drink Hurricane.
Hey, I'm going to disappoint a lot of the fans, but I'm going to use some discretion right now. I'm going to end this live. We've addressed everything that we needed to address. Okay? There's nothing else to talk about. We're moving on. Peace has been made. And guess what? Those that had all this power, they had all this power and laughing and everything, it's all over now. It's over. Jay, have a great night. Get something to eat. Go to bed. Or do another live.
Do another line?
Make sure to grind it real well.
Bill just said he benched 405 for 25 reps. I think that's a fake Dale Chance account.
I pinned a question that Dale Chance had. He said, what about benching with a slingshot? Are you familiar with a slingshot?
Yeah, I mean, yes and no. I mean, I know they work for a lot of people, especially people with rotator cuff injuries, but, you know, I don't see the purpose of putting a slingshot on so that you can still lift heavy. You know, when I've got a sore rotator cuff, I like to just go to Planet Fitness, get on the Smith machine, go light, get some blood flow. I don't see the purpose of the slingshot.
Well, there you have it. Look. All right, Jay, man, you have a good night. I'm signing off. I got thick 1-inch pork chops to go cook. All right, man, love you.
I feel like you're giving me an abortion.
Discretion. We've addressed everything we need to address. I love you, man. I'm acting as your lawyer.
You think I have a drinking problem?
I have a drinking problem. Love you.